Power just went out, your phone's at 12%, the fridge is off, your Wi-Fi is out, and you have no lights. And you realize you weren't prepared. But there is something that most people don't know about, and once you have it, you realize power outage isn't such an emergency anymore. Power outages are more common than ever. Recently, we've been having tons of storms, fires, brownouts, blackouts. Even just if you live in a condo building and they're building around you, construction workers knock out the power all the time.
Not to mention when squirrels like just get zapped.
In some places, people are having power outages every month, and sometimes it's as bad as every week. And most people are stuck in the dark when that happens, literally. Over 70% of Americans have experienced at least one power outage in the last year, and less than 25% of them actually had a backup power solution. And of that 25%, only 5% of them were prepared the right way. If you weren't one of that small percentage of people, you're probably relying on candles, flashlights, or nothing at all. Ice in the fridge? Come on. You might have a gas generator, which can serve a purpose, and we actually do recommend them in certain situations. But the reality is, they're loud, they stink, they can't be indoors, and they usually run out of fuel when you need them most because they have to be running 100% of the time. But there's a better way. This is a power station. It's a portable battery that has all of the plugs and ports you need to not only charge it up, but to power all of the devices in your home. You can charge this thing by simply plugging it into your wall before a storm or running solar into it if the power is already out. It can power your fridge, your phone, your Wi-Fi, a heater, a fan, a portable air conditioner, pretty much anything you need, you can power with something like this. And bigger ones could even power things like your washer and dryer, your oven and stove. The point is, whatever you want to power, you can get a power station that can do it. Something like this, there's no gas, there's no noise, just peace of mind. You can run this thing inside of your house, your condo, plane, car, boat, truck, wherever you're at, you can use this thing. Even a small $400 or $500 power station can keep you powered for 1 to 2 days if you're just trying to keep on the essentials. And bigger ones like these can run your fridge, furnace, CPAPs, anything like that for days. So how do you choose the unit that's best for your needs? That's our entire job here at the lab. We put all power stations through real world testing to find out if they're worth your hard earned money. From cheap ones to really expensive ones, we make sure to recommend you guys to companies and products that actually work and call out any BS companies that are just trying to make a quick buck, don't offer customer support, and are probably making a garbage product. As a result, we recommend power stations that actually solve your problems from companies that actually have support. We even built a quiz, so if you guys are confused or you don't understand everything, you can take that super quick quiz and it'll give you an instant recommendation for a power station that we recommend that fits your needs. Anyways, here's the things that you actually want to look for. Make sure you get a power station with a battery that is LiFePO4. These batteries are safer, they last way longer. You can literally cycle them from full to zero every single day for 10 years before the battery health is at 80%. Any other older battery chemistry, it's not going to last as long, it's not as good of an investment. You want to look for a unit that has a power output or an inverter size of at least 1,000 watts if you're trying to make it through a blackout. In our opinion, that's a really good starter size. That'll be able to run all the essentials, but also handle a little bit extra if you have everything running at one time. And a battery bank of at least about 1,500 watt hours. The average fridge uses about 1,300 watts per day, so 1,500 watt hours is gonna get you at least 24 hours of confident backup power. We recommend you look for something that is solar ready with a decent size solar input. We like to see the solar input be about half the size of the battery. That means you could charge it up pretty quickly. And you're gonna want this because if the power is out for multiple days on end and you need to recharge this thing, you can literally put it out in the sun with some solar panels, charge it right back up to full, get it back in the house, and keep powering all of your essentials. And finally, we just recommend making sure that all the plugs that you're gonna need to power your devices are on the unit. So in this case, this has general 120 volt house plugs. It also has a 30 amp, that's good for trailers and things like that. But you can also get adapters for these 30 amps to run something like your dryer. So just find out what you want to power and make sure that the plugs are on the unit. If you watch any of our other reviews, you'll also notice that I'm a really big fan of 12 volt car sockets. This lets you run something like a small 12 volt fridge or take this camping. It's a great thing to have. And a light. This unit has no light. I'm a big fan of units with lights. When the power's out, turn on the light. You walk around with it, you can see what you're doing 10 times better. When it comes to looking at companies, if you're trying to find something more affordable, more of like a budget brand, we recommend looking at Pecron. They make good power stations for a price that we honestly don't know how they stay in business, but they are a good product for the price and they've been around the block. They've been around for a while. We know that they aren't going anywhere. If you're trying to spend a little more money, get a product from a company that has a little bit better customer support or is just a little more premium, you can look at a company like EcoFlow or Anker. They are probably the two industry leaders right now. The units will generally have all the same features in terms of plugs and ports, but they usually have a little bit of a better app, better customer support, and they're usually built to integrate into your home a little bit more seamlessly if that's the route you're trying to go. There's a lot of cheap shit out there, and a lot of people are really incentivized to go save as much money as possible and buy a really cheap power station.
And there's a lot of creators promoting that shit because they're getting paid.
That is also a very good point. You got to watch out whose videos you're watching because we personally accept zero money. Our opinions cannot be bought here. But we've tested a lot of products that they're medium, and every time you use it, it just seems to get a little bit worse. So if you're trying to save some money, go with at least a trusted cheap brand like Pecron. If you buy a real knockoff product, it might just not work when you need it to. But we have tons of videos if you want to learn more about specific units and brands. We even have videos mystery shopping companies to find out how good their support actually is. At the end of the day, most people find out about power stations after it's too late. Don't be one of those people. Get your hands on something. Power outages are becoming way too common these days to not be prepared. If you want a quick recommendation, like I said earlier, just take the quiz that we made down below. Make sure you guys are subscribed and check out some other videos if you haven't already. Otherwise, that is all we got for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.